Welcome back, everybody. It's Paul Maglev here, and today we are going to take a look at the future era. It's future era or bust, everybody. And you know why? Because I'm on the verge of almost crashing my hard drive because it's almost out of space. So let's get started, shall we? This is probably going to be the last episode in the recording session. The future is now! Wow! Cities have grown high and trains are more efficient than ever, but engineers still need to figure out how to avoid spaghetti railways. And that is where we come in. Warning, trains can run on more than one level of track. This is something that you couldn't see in Trains Trouble, and I like that very much, so all we have to do is just get our Maglev train up and over here. Up to over here, there we go. And it even goes down because it's able to handle steep gradients like the real Maglev trains. Which is why they have the multi-level system, but it's also for a nice game mechanic, so that is also nice. So we got ourselves two different trains bound for two different stations. This shouldn't be too difficult. I think that's pretty much all there is to it for this level. Most players, when they experience this for the first time, they experience the sensation of being overwhelmed. And for some reason, that train isn't holding a blue flag. But anyway, use the accelerator at the right time to temporarily increase the speed of your train. So when we push this while the train's on top, it basically just speeds it up like a track booster on a Hot Wheels set. So we got three trains here, all in their prerequisite configurations. Then I need to flip this switch, and then we're gonna need to flip this switch. Nope. At least I got the green train in. Oops. And we had a fatal collision once again. Oh, I think I know what to do now. Speed boost. Speed boost. Speed boost. Nope. That didn't work. So we're just going to hit this. Flip the switch, hit this. So that these trains don't collide. Ah, shucks. So we got ourselves the boost. Got ourselves the second boost. Well, that didn't work. So we need a first boost to get us by. Let's see, we need a boost here. Then we need a boost. Oh. Oh. Oh, I think I know what I need to do now. The green train needs to be boosted first. Then the blue train. And then the red train can do its thing. Okay, so we've got that. Got that. Got that. Okay, that's better. I think we did it! Except we didn't get any stars. I really thought that would have been par for the course, in terms of the number of clicks I needed to do. Maybe it's because I double-clicked a few times. This reminds me of Pod Racers for some reason. And the water texture actually isn't broken. I'm trying to think how I'm going to do this. Well, I'm obviously not going to do it like this in the future, because I just know they're on a... Oh, they're not on a collision course. Aw, oh, man, the red station was right there! Now it's just a question of what I'm going to do now. Because the way this train is going, it's just going to keep looping around indefinitely. I think I've made a terrible mistake. Let's try that again. I think this will work more to my liking. There we go. Then we can flip this and this. Okay, that'll do it. For Maglev trains, they're pretty slow. Beam trains up. Guide trains towards teleporters to reach the destination. You know, with teleporters, you'd think that they'd be able to just use them instead of having to use the trains, but I guess that's just part of the game. I don't know. Game logic. Oh, that just happened. They're like tunnels, but for teleporting stuff. Still would have been smarter just to have teleporters in between destination points. Kind of like in Rick and Morty, where they have like the portal airports or whatever. Where after they go through clearance, they just walk into the portal to the dimension they want to go to. This level looks very familiar in terms of its principle. Guess which tunnel goes where? Let's see if we guessed it right. Nope. Well, at least we got the green one right. Green, red, we're almost there, almost there. All you have to do for the moment is absolutely nothing, then we flip this switch, then we flip this switch, and this switch. That should do it. And everyone's going to be at their desired destination. Oh dear god. This reminds me of one of those little contraption toys we used to have as kids. I didn't mean to flip that, but okay. Flip this, flip this, flip this, flip this, flip this. Oops. Don't worry, we'll be able to try it again. Oops. Oops. No! Why must this keep happening to me? Nope. 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 Nope, and nope. So our first train's gonna go this way. Then we're gonna flip this train into this track. Then we're gonna go up and over, down, through some convoluted mess that I can't understand. So we're gonna go down this way, and we're gonna make a turn here. And then we're gonna make a turn here. Oh, that was the end. Oh right, the red station's over here. It's two stations stacked on top of each other for some inexplicable reason. Because science fiction, that's why. flip this switch. Then we'll flip this switch. I clicked it twice and it decided not to do what I wanted it to do. It's a piece of shit. Even in the future, technology is unreliable. And my phone is ringing. Fan-fucking-tastic. Hopefully no one's able to hear that. But I might have to record this level all over again because of that interruption. I won't know for sure until post-edit. This one's gonna be weird. I'm trying to think how this is going to work. Oops. But at least I got one in! Where's the yellow station's here, so it pulls in like this. Then the blue train goes up and over. And the red train goes over and back. Okay, I think I can manage that. Sort of. I guess not! Okay, that'll do it. Oops. Wow, I had prepared saying oops the moment I realized something was wrong, which was obviously a little too late. There we have it! Simple pimple. It's just a matter of implementation. Now I'm wondering how this is going to be done. Is the blue train over here, behind this building? Maybe. Some clarification would help. Okay, that's good. Oops. I forgot something, didn't I? Yes, I did. And the markings are still there from the pre- Oh. Okay. So we'll try this again. Flip these tracks. I'm trying to think. I'm gonna have this train go this way and the other train go the other way. There we go. And one more switch for good measure. That should do it. Now here's a weird level. Now it's just a carousel. It's all a matter of where and when things need to be put in correctly. Oops. I was close! But no cigar. Anyway. Anybody else notice that the textures for broken trains are the same across all the different, areas? Regardless of the locomotive type? Let's see, so we will need just a little bit more time to configure in my head what I am supposed to do. There we go. 3 stars. This is gonna be potentially difficult. keyword being potentially. Oh, well, that's not a good thing. Gotta loop around. Well, that's not what I had in mind. But that's what happened anyway! I think I've got an idea. It might be so crazy that it'll just work. Nope. Not even close. Wait, I got an idea. A second idea. If I put these switches, then I won't have to worry about the crazy traffic. And then they'll go to their respective stations like they're supposed to. Okay, this works much better. It was a lot easier than it looked. I'll just say that, because that's really all I can say. This is one of the other levels I was trying to practice with. That didn't happen when I was practicing this game. Oh. Did I switch this back prematurely? Dang it. Wait for it. There. And the switch did not engage. That'll do it. Just thinking how I'm going to strategize this. Flip it around. Oops. There's always one switch I overlook. There we go. And it happened again! Cause sure, why not? Didn't happen all the jillion other times. Oops. Shippickle, 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 shippickle. This plan is going to work. All we have to do is just loop the train around, and we should be good to go. We only got one star, though. Doesn't really matter, though. It's just a matter of waiting. Stupid yellow train's always the last one in these levels. Any day now, yellow train! Another incident of pod racing. Just trying to think how I'm going to configure this. Loop things around. Okay. Oh, that didn't work. I'm trying to think how I'm going to try to avoid doing that mistake again. Oops. No, I didn't mean to do that. Okay. Flip these switches, and we'll get the... Why did I do that again? Ah, jeez. One of these days. Actually, no, I need to switch it over now. Then we can flip this over. Flip this over again. We didn't get any stars. And I forgot the switch. Even though my mouse cursor was clearly on top of it. I admit, that time around, I actually didn't click when I was supposed to. Trying to think of how I'm going to approach this one last time. Okay, that's better. That should have everything all sorted out. Ooh, this looks neat. I think Trains Trouble had a level like this, except it didn't have Maglev trains. I was close! Ah, come on! That's a load of crap. Why didn't I get all the stars? I did everything as efficiently as possible. Well, that just happened. That also happened. Okay, so I need to flip this switch and this switch, and this switch, and this switch. Speed boost. And I need to decide what to do with that other train after everything is said and done. Ah, that was so close, too! Okay. Speed boost. Over. Fuck me! And everyone died. The end. Flip this switch. Done! Something that should have been absolutely simple, complicated 10 times more by my complete stupidity. Well, that didn't work like I hoped. Let's see if inaction is the best form of action. It is not. Inaction is definitely just as bad as what I had done previously. Just trying to think how I'm gonna do this. I need to have rapid punctuality. There we go. I think I was trying to get stars on this as well in my training. When I was warming up the other day to play this level. How did I do it? I'm trying to remember how I did this nonsense. I think the first thing I need to do is flip this around. That was a terrible mistake. I don't know how I did it before! Oh, that's how I did it. Because not everything had sped up yet. And I sent a train to the wrong station. We will not make the same mistake. Not again. Just need to flip this little switch. Flip this little switch. Just a few more switches and we should be good to go. That's 2 out of 4. I hit the wrong one. I meant to hit the one next to it. But hopefully everything works out. That should do it. Oops. Just because I think I know what I'm doing doesn't mean I actually do. Just one more try. Ought to do it. Put this. Flip this. That should do it. That should do it. Yeah, this totally works. But it only gets me 2 stars. Instead of the 3 I wanted. See what this level entails. First, this needs to be looping around. This also has to be looping around, otherwise we're gonna be in some big trouble. Oh boy. Flip it. There we go. This is strange. Oh, I think I... Oh, there's a whole nother set of track I didn't even notice. One that goes down this way and another that's symmetrically going the other way. And I forgot the switches. That's better. Gotta work on that timing, though. Selective perception's a bitch. We're gonna have to wait until the blue train and the red train make it to their respective stations. We can't risk it. And then that happened. Always a switch I overlook. That should be one of the golden rules of this game. You will forget a switch. There are no exceptions. That should do it. Then we'll be able to flip this and this. That's better. And now we're just sitting pretty because everything seems to have worked out finally. This is gonna be a weird one. It's a matter of where these portals go to. We'll have to find out the hard way. Yep, that was not the right configuration. Red train needs to go in here, blue train... No, the train that goes after that's probably yellow. So we're just gonna flip this, return this back to its stationary position. Hopefully this works out, please. Nope! It's all counterclockwise, I think. But let's double check just to be sure. I want to see where the other portals go to. They might be completely random. It's the yellow train. Okay. So now we have a general understanding of where everything's supposed to go. So we need the red train to go in here. To go here. We need the green train to go in here. Shoot, this is more confusing than I first thought. Okay, so that goes there. I'm trying to remember. What does the other one go to? Just happened a second ago, I should know these things. Well, no stars for me then. But we made it through, that's all that matters. This is gonna be weird. Could be all sorts of weird. Flip. Ah, shucks. But I know what I must do. Actually, no, I take that back. I have no idea what I'm doing. The way everything's set up, if I send a train out from here and to here, it's just gonna get stuck. If my memory is correct... If I delay the process of transferring different trains to the desired destinations, then I might stand a chance. Not the most efficient way of doing it, but it was a way of doing it. And here's the craziest level of them all, I think. Oops. Okay, that should do it. Okay, that's better. Beat your game! Beat your stupid level. That was disproportionately hard for what it was supposed to be. I'm trying to think how I'm gonna work this out. Because the green train needs to come up this way and then up and over. Something tells me this isn't going to end well. And my suspicions were correct. And I sent a train in the wrong direction. Let's see if this plan works out. Nope. I gotta get the feelings for it. Just gotta get myself ready. Nope. That didn't work. I wanted this train to go up and over, but this train come up and over and then get to here before the blue train crossed. Wait, I think I know... Ugh, why was I overlooking such a simple detail? I can't believe I was overlooking such a simple detail the whole time. I was supposed to have the red train go through here instead of through there. What was I thinking? Ooh. So we got ourselves a tiny green train, a tiny blue train, a tiny yellow train, and a big red train. Let's see what could possibly go wrong. So everything's been locked into place. Now it's just a matter of figuring out how to get into the Oh! Well, that's one way to get into the teleporter. That wasn't as complicated as I thought it was going to be. Yep, that was way easier than it was supposed to be. And then up and over. Okay, that should do it. Oh, wait, up! Whew! Me and my dead cat reflexes finally actually did something for once. Or should I say, my dead cat reflexes and I did it! I saved the future from itself. The future is mine! And also yours too, but still. Be prepared for new challenges revisiting the railroad history. So, and yeah, that's pretty much all there is to it. There's just some challenge levels that come after the future era, which I can actually do if you want me to do them, but I think this is going to wrap up this recording session in this episode, so I will see you all in the next series, in the next episode of Train Crisis? Who knows? Just submit a comment or something. Tell me what you want. Do you want more of this? Or do you want something else? There's a comment section for that. Please submit something there to give me an idea of what you want. Because all I want to do is just give you what you want. Anyway. Something that pleases me as well. But anyway, I'm getting ahead of myself. Thank you all for watching. Take care. Stay awesome. Stay true to yourself. And remember to never give up. I will see you at some future point in time. Bye, everybody.